All right, Mr. D, let's see if we can tackle some garden math.
Gardening math. Yeah, yeah, I hate math.
I think we all concur.
Yeah.
But math is a big part of, you know, putting down fertilizers, putting down pesticides. So you have to know a little math.
That's right,
so
kids.
So when they told you to pay attention in the algebra class,
you better
do
that. You better. You got it. You're going to have to use it.
Yes, you're going to have to use it.
Fortunately, we have calculators now that help. And there are a few apps out there that give you a little bit of help too. But you better. It's good to be able to know how to do it so you can kind of cross-check and make sure you got it right. It's really important that you do it right, and you may want to, like I said, double-check, because one little decimal point can make a big difference. Two decimal points makes a real big difference. So, if you're supposed to get 10%, you know, 0.1 instead of, or 0.01,
right.
0.1, you know, that's very
makes
important.
Makes a difference, no doubt about that.
But, you know, the important thing, when you're a lot of the pesticides and fertilizers and soil test reports and things like that will break homeowners' information down to 1,000 square feet sometimes per 100 square feet. Most of the time it's per 1,000 square feet. So probably the most important thing you can do first is determine how many square feet that you're treating. And, you know, we all know that in order to find the area of a rectangle, you multiply the length times the width, and it'll give you the square in feet, and it'll give you the square feet, or in inches, it'll give you the square inches. And if you have a lot, I would determine the area of the lot first, and then I would determine the area of your house and subtract that from your total square footage of your lot, measure the area of your driveway, subtract that, measure the area of your patio, subtract that, the area of your dog pen, subtract that, the area of your swimming pool, subtract that, the area of your workshop, subtract that, and when you've done all of that, you will pretty much have the area, total area in square footage that you're treating. So then you'll know how much product to buy. And then when you if you're using a fertilizer, keep in mind most of the soil test reports will tell you how much nitrogen you need per 1,000 square feet. They're not going to tell you how much triple 15 you need, because you may not have triple 15. You may have triple 10 or 6-12-12 or 34-00 or there's a lot of different formulations of fertilizer. So they're going to tell you how much active ingredient you need per 1,000 square feet. And then when you buy that product, whatever you come up with, if it calls for 10 pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet, and you've got a 34% product, then you've got to reduce the amount. You're going to increase the total amount of the product you put out to get that 34%. You've got to bring it down to 34%. Same way with a 10%. Triple 10 would be real easy. You know, if you would need to put 10 pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet, then you're going to put, if you have triple 10, be 100. I think 100 pounds of triple 10 that you're going to have to put out there. That'd be two bags of fertilizer.
Right.
So if it's a 50-pound bag. So just double-check everything. Use algebra, use your algebraic expressions. I have to write it down and look at it. I try to do it in my head, I'm gonna make a mess. So write it down and then cross multiply, cross check, and then make sure you've got it right. Because you don't wanna, you can add more. So if you underestimate, you can go back and you can add more, but it's pretty hard to take up if you put too much out there. And putting too much out there with fertilizer can contaminate our water supplies, and it can create problems. It can create algae blooms and things like that. Don't feel like just because you have a 50-pound bag of fertilizer, you've got to use it all. It will keep. You can roll it up, put you some duct tape on it, and use it next year. Just use what you need. And with herbicides, if you put out more than you're supposed to put out, you can kill desirable, grass. Some of the herbicides may be, targeted to just broadleaves, but if you go way, more than you're supposed to, you may kill everything that you got out there.
For sure.
So it's important to to follow label directions, and unfortunately, you got to use math.
All right. Well, speaking of using math, you want to get to our math problem?
Well, let's do a math problem. Yeah.
Let's see if we can do one quickly.
Okay.
So set us up here. What do we have?
Have I got to show you my scratching here on this? I can do that. I can do that. What I've got here is triple 15 fertilizer, okay, and the soil test recommendation calls for 10 pounds per 1,000 square feet. So I know that I have 4,000 square feet that I need to treat.
Okay.
I've done all my subtractions and additions and multiplications, and I've got a 4,000 square feet I need to treat. So I just set up an algebraic expression. Okay, 10 pounds per 1,000 square feet. I've got 4,000 square feet. So 4 times 10 is 40 pounds. I need 40 pounds of nitrogen, okay, on my 4,000 square feet. And I'm using 15, triple 15. So triple 15 is 15% nitrogen, 15% phosphorus, and 15% potash.
Correct.
And so I've got a 15% material. So I set it up. You know, 40 pounds is 15% of what? 40 pounds just happens to be 15% of 266.66. So I need 266.66 pounds of triple 15 on that
4,000
square feet. See, it's a weak material. So and the triple 15 is 45%. Now in that, you're also getting the same amount of potassium,
right,
and the same amount of phosphate. So 15 triple 15 is 45% fertilizer and 55% inert ingredients.
Material, yeah, as they say, or ingredient.
So there's a lot of fertilizer in there. But so that, you know, I don't, 266 pounds, how many bags is that? That's quite a bit of fertilizer.
Yeah. And I think they come in, what, 40, maybe 40, 50-pound bags?
And 10 pounds of nitrogen is a lot of nitrogen. I just threw that out there. It may be probably 1 pound or 1 to 3 pound is probably a more common recommendation on nitrogen fertilizer. Mm-hmm. So that was just an example that I used. So.
Yeah. And, of course, we know nitrogen moves pretty quickly through the soil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. You know, it's going to be there if it's not encapsulated, if it's not slow-release form. Mm. It will be gone in 4 to 6 weeks. Yeah. You know, a lot of rain, 4 weeks, yeah, 6 weeks.
Good point.
If there's not too much rain, 4 to 6 weeks, it's gone.
Your algebra teacher would be proud of you, Mr. D. Thank you.
No,
much.
No. Trust me, she wouldn't.
Well, we appreciate that math question for us, all right?
Thank you.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please click the subscribe button below.